It's a parking lot. 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 It's a parking lot.
I know it's a parking lot, but for years, whenever I parked and left to go about my business, I always wondered, where am I going that's better than this? So one day, I stopped and decided to stay and meet the people in Harmony Lot.
Oh, it's time for a Harmony sing-along, kids.
Okay.
Gather around.
Stop putting away the...
Maxwell. I'm here a fair bit. A lot of my friends hang out here. I skateboard here a fair bit, you know. Been hanging out here for a couple years.
My name's Rhiannon. Well, I'm here to find my friends so that I won't, and to, yeah, find something to do.
I don't know quite how most people start hanging out here. I started hanging out here because in the common ground, before it was fancy like it is now, did a lot of shows there and stuff. And
I mean, I like it. All my friends are here, but it's kind of a dead zone.
Kind of boring place.
Well, during the summer when we're not working, we swim, we go on hikes, and then like usual we'll go hang out at houses and stuff and work if we work and...
Kind of a hole that you get trapped in. It's kind of a place you can go and there's usually people here to hang out with.
What usual kids do, just, we do it and start here.
I mean, there's a lot of bands that hang out around here. The Tinderbox is another reason why people, that just kind of opened last summer, I think. There's a lot of time where it's really fun, and you hang out with your friends, and then there's a lot of time where everybody's bored, and you just kind of sit around and smoke cigarettes and stuff.
Here's a poem for today by Wynn Cooper, entitled Postcard from Harmony Parking Lot. The teens have gathered because they are teens. They wear brown shirts, faded to beige,
black boots,
low slung jeans.
The way they stand is called jaunty. Cigarettes burn through their words, smoke blows through their hair, and the way they stare at passers-by blends reptile with bird, spleen with wonder, your past with their present to you.
You have a lot of people that are intelligent in Vermont. I think Vermont, we're book readers here. And that's good about Vermont. We're very liberal, open-minded, and that's what's beautiful about Vermont.
The way I feel about Harmony Lot is an extension of the way I feel about Brattleboro. I feel like I'm very favored to live in this place. It's alive, it's vibrant, it believes in things that I believe in.
And we care about the how our children are growing up. And so, you gotta come out and relate. Well, we got the chalkboard for the children and the people in the Harmony parking lot to draw on. rather than painting on the walls or making marks on the wall, they get creative on the chalkboard.
Yeah.
They got the chalkboard originally for the common ground, but it didn't fit up there. So Ian and a couple of his friends bolted it to the wall outside down there, and I supply the chalk, and it's been a big hit ever since. Well, I get along great. They all know me. I know them. I'm 51 years old. I'm hanging with kids that are 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 23, 27. We have a wide range of people here in the Harmony parking lot.
I actually prefer to be anonymous in public works. My little gift to humanity.
Keeps the kids creative and keeps our Harmony parking lot looking nice.
Well, we support them, but also, you know, they can be a headache. And, you know, when I was a teenager, I was a headache, and I still am a headache to some people, I'm sure. Most of the time, people are just hanging out here, and that's fine. But, you know, sometimes they'll, do something ridiculous that can be a headache.
We drank a lot of milk.
The
whole gallon challenge. You have to drink a whole gallon of milk in an hour. And we tried it, and we puked everywhere. Yeah.
4 out of 5 of us threw up.
Yeah.
Sometimes, spray painting the street.
Good times. Good times.
Quality food.
What flavor is it?
Vanilla.
And it's a wonderful place. I mean, I might have said a bunch of bad things, but I still love the place, and I still want people to hang out here. It's an interesting place.
I'm Mo. This is Andrew. We're Harmony Rats. We're using colors to brighten our world.
A Harmony Rat is someone who generally just hangs out here a lot.
Yeah, I try to live by example. This bike, ay ay ay.
So people just drop them off here underneath the blackboard, and you find them and fix them?
Yep.
And give them away?
Yep. That's how it works.
I just like working with putzing around with my hands.
Yeah, we work with bikes. That's what we do.
So could you tell us your name?
Teddy.
And how'd you get started fixing bikes here with Ian?
We met at the Pathways.
We've been doing this for four years, I think.
Yeah.
We started doing this when Audrey was running the Pathways for Youth. That was the perfect spot in the whole world. It's just what made us fall in love with doing this here. And when it couldn't persist anymore, we just had to keep doing it. So we did it here. And then in the winter, we do it up in the tinderbox.
Once a week, you come out here and every Thursday?
Oh, well, every Thursday we come out here at 4 until like 6. I don't know. Anything besides that? No.
So you say you don't charge anybody?
No, that's part of the point, because sharing and, sharing knowledge and doing things, giving people, doing good service. I do it, because I believe in it, and it kind of just needs to be done. And that's why, I even pay money out of my pocket for parts or for rent at the tinderbox for storage. But, I don't care about money. I think money is a evil thing, really. I do it because it's fun.
You will accept a donation, right?
I do, because, we all need money to survive, but...
So, Ian, the kids told me that those things up there are rockets, and every once in a while, the place takes off.
The lesser-known facts about the Common Ground is, those things right up there, rocket engines.
Are they actually really? A spaceship?
They use that to go into space.
I've only seen it used once.
Yeah.
Those rockets right there, they just go...
Common Ground lifts off, and...
Yeah.
We have our own little hippie commune on Mars that we're...
Shut the hell up!
Sorry.
It totally happens, The Common Ground Millennium Falcon takes off. You're gonna film this and people are gonna watch and be like, hey, I'll figure out how to do that.
get a lot of bike donations, don't you?
Yeah, this one was a donation, but I know someone that needs one right now.
Like donating to a good cause? Ian's here every Thursday from 4 to 6. You'll see him out here. Throw him some bucks if you believe in the cause.
Okay, Francis.
So all it takes is guidance without them even knowing it. You know, you want to hang and be with people that are intelligent, knowledgeable, people that read books.
Hi, everybody. My name is Jona Isufi, and I'm from Albania. The first thing that caught my attention was a bookstore. I found this interesting one which says Jobs Rated Almanac. And looking at the books, I picked up three books which were free. Harmony Parking Lot is quite interesting and it gives much color to this town.
I'm Bethany Larson and I work for Youth Services in a juvenile restorative justice project. Well, this is the community's project, but I started it back in October. I wanted to do a large-scale project that everybody could come down and do community service hours or just be involved in the community. I work with youth who have community service hours to do. They're on probation, and I wanted a way that they could connect with the community and do their part to repair the harm their actions have caused. Hi, this is the artist, Chris, coming up right now.
This is the actual design. Brattleboro has a long publishing history. One of the first industries here in town was publishing. People had presses. There's bookstores all around. Harmony Lot seems to have, there's about four bookstores within, you know, eyesight or yelling distance of where we are right now.
Kind of addressing the problem with graffiti in areas and what to do to solve this problem. And they've found in other towns that putting up murals and putting up artwork deters people from defacing that wall or that area. Ready to take on Brattleboro, bring the community together.
And I didn't want to leave him hanging by himself, so I told him I'd help him.
Well, you're a good friend.
I like to think so. Jesus, man.
Good turnout, excellent weather, and it's working.
Nice day, thought I'd come out and help.
Give kindness, you're going to get kindness back. Give a negative attitude, you're only going to make it grow.
Let me duel him! Let me duel him! We have to have a duel!
Yeah, my name is Kellyanne, and I thought that this would be a great event for the people of Brattleboro to get involved in and try to release some inner frustrations of these hard times.
Take him down! Oh!
All right, give it another round.
I think that it turned out, and the people that are here are having a really good time, but I have to be honest, I was hoping more people would come.
What is all this?
It's snowing! Welcome to Vermont!
Well, because I'm in a wheelchair, and I don't like getting hit with a pillow in a wheelchair. I weigh over 500 pounds. You don't need me running into you. It's quite the mess. All right, who's going to clean this up?
You are.
But I know in the 40s and 50s, I think, there. I mean, it's always had a party atmosphere.
I mean.
There is a history, I think, of... partying
and having fun. I had a facelift, got a little Irish thing going on, you know, but I really am. I'm EDIV. Yep.
Well, when I was a teenager, I used to go to the Village Burn and go back and forth between there and Alice's restaurant. It was certainly a different parking lot then.
Oh yeah, my name's Michael Allen, king of the club kids.
Brattleboro was a completely different town now. I think they progressed rather nicely. Something that everybody could use, where Brattleboro was known when I was a teenager for having more bars per capita than any other place in the country.
Hi, I'm Uncle Al. Last name, Caholic.
Yes, it was quite a rowdy town back then.
I haven't seen you in a while, so that's a positive.
Hi! Hi, Ma! I have a little bit of fun. I go home. Trying to keep it clean.
Yeah, everybody used to drive around and go from different nightclub to nightclub. And that was the nightly thing, but this is certainly a pleasant change from what it used to be.
Then, in the summer of 2007, I missed a couple of weeks when things went bad in the lot. People formed a neighborhood association and held their first meeting.
As I walked around downtown the last week talking to people who live, work, and hang out in Harmony, I heard appalling stories of violence, drug dealing.
One of our local drug dealers pulled up and complained to me that you looked all suspicious with your camera. He wanted me to check on you. And that made him leave the lot. And I thought it was pretty humorous that just you sitting here with your camera and not even having it on made him leave the parking lot.
Trash, people being intimidated. And it occurred to me that it didn't sound like Brattleboro at all. People don't feel safe here, and that's not okay.
I would call this parking lot the heart of Brattleboro.
The very heart of our community has become a place where people in this community don't want to be. Historically, neighborhood associations have been very successful across the country and here in Brattleboro. I'm glad everyone's here, and hopefully this will set us on a path or give us a direction to really reclaim the Harmony Lot in that area.
What do we like about Harmony Lot? What works there? And what could work better? That's going to be the kind of focus of our discussion.
This gathering feeling, so people have a tendency to want to gather there, and why I'm attracted to the place.
You walk in and there's, you know, the bakery and the bookstore and the restaurants, and I like that keeps our town unique, that it's not box stores, you know, that we have thriving businesses in there.
That I can get anything I want, it's within walking distance, and I like that. And it's very important to me as I get older to feel safe in this environment. And certainly, just this last summer, I've begun to feel less and less safe as I've gone about my business and hurried back before it's got dark and not gone out too early in the morning either.
And seeing the kids hanging out and stuff, I like that. I like when I know who, you know, the kids hanging out don't bother me. I like seeing them there. I think it gives them a place to go.
My name is Melival from the Commonwealth Bakery. My wife and I have been coming to Brattleboro for 3 years, and now that we have the bakery there, I see the Harmony parking lot as a great place, like an Areopagus in Greece of old, to exchange ideas in a free atmosphere, and we're very glad to be there. I've seen some towns in Vermont and New Hampshire that die in the center. There no longer is a place to meet in the center or freedom. The River Garden is supposed to be that, but the Harmony parking lot can lend itself to that at any time.
I agree that the kids, I love watching them, but there's a different element.
I love going there. I love the diversity of it. And when I leave, I just smile.
I like the Harmony parking lot because it has even more potential than we're saying. I also like it because there's activity. It just seems like the town is alive there, or it can be. And you can look out your window and you can see people all the time.
Not that I don't mind the rain, but not now.
Yeah, I gotta get one of
those. Just a really nice feeling to see people shopping, people active, people being able to communicate, people socializing, like my husband said, even exchanging ideas about farming, about anything, you know, and that's why I like it.
The local business community has worked very hard to keep a downtown as a downtown, and this makes us unique and wonderful.
It's a parking lot. It's a parking lot.
Could you identify yourself?
Yes. My name is Mark. It's a parking lot.
Okay. So a good thing about Harmony Lot is that it actually accommodates vehicles.
Yeah, it's
so
it's,
people
it's
can
made specially for parking lot.
Okay. No.
Hi, Ma.
Start to point that out.
Once a friend of mine from New York came over, and he got a $5 parking ticket, and he said that in New York, he pays for 15 minutes, he pays $5. And here he got a ticket of $5. And then the ticket was actually forgiven because that was his first time. So he said, suckers, and left.
And here, one of the reasons I like it, and I know Nancy likes it from everyone's books, is that it's convenient for delivery people to bring our shipments into our stores, and we don't have to block up Elliott Street.
Yeah, I love Harmony Lot. It makes my life much simpler to have Harmony Lot. Because of where it is. It's very centrally located.
I like Harmony Lot because it's kind of a mirror to Main Street. If you don't know it's there and you discover it for the first time, it's this interesting area that is behind Main Street. A lot of small town Main Streets don't have anything like that. So the first time you go in there to the Harmony Lot, you're confronted with something that is interesting and alive and vital.
Thought the town was awesome, so we decided to try coming back. And this is about our fourth or fifth time coming back.
And one that I haven't heard, although I couldn't hear everybody's comments, a number of years ago, Harmony Lot underwent sort of a makeover, and there were some trees put in there. I like the fact that there are at least some trees.
When we built the garage on Elliott Street, I don't know if there's any truth to this at all, but the rumor that I kept hearing was this idea that we were going to turn the Harmony parking lot into the Harmony Park.
A park? Like if it was grass?
Now that never happened. I don't know if it ever was supposed to happen, but for years I've just thought, what a great idea that would be.
Well, I mean, I think part of it is that you park your car here. So, like, if you're going to do anything in town, you have to come here first.
Constantine von Krusenstern with United Way. I don't think anyone mentioned the murals yet. I love the murals on the walls.
Just one word off of the murals, the blackboard.
Yes.
Like the blackboard.
We gave them this chalkboard here so that they can have something to do art on instead of graffiti.
Harmony Place got its name. This little acre of land behind Brooks' house has always been an open space. You could park your horse here. It became a town parking lot in the 1950s.
If you were doing this documentary 2 years ago, it would have been a very different documentary, I think. 2 years ago, this was all people playing music and like drawing on the sidewalk with chalk and stuff, and you know, doing a lot of pretty cool stuff, I thought, at the time. And it has changed a little bit. Everybody at the meeting was saying how nice Harmony used to be, how they liked seeing all the kids there, but that was not the impression I got when I was hanging out there 2 years ago. I think, I feel like now that this much more aggressive crowd has moved in, they wish we were back. You know, it's kind of a, you know, like with lawyers, you hate them till you need them. I think it's kind of funny hearing all these people talk about how nice the kids in Harmony used to be when at the time when we were hanging out in Harmony, I felt like that wasn't the impression that we were getting at all. People didn't like kids hanging out in Harmony, it's just loitering. I think in the end people have realized that was a lot more healthy. And just healthy in general, not even more healthy.
I'm Josh. I live on 67 Main. I've been a member of the community for 15 or so years. From my standpoint, when I was, you know, a little bit younger than I am now, there used to be, it was a gathering spot. People would play drums or didgeridoos or hacky sack. It was just kind of like a little subculture in this little, you know, piece of Brattleboro. I mean, this place used to get packed.
She's got a picture of a guru taped over the temperature. Crystals and feathers and driftwood and a bundle of sage. And her 82 Toyotas transformed to an altar on wheels. There is a spiritual presence to each mile. Faithful fields. She said, when I was a kid, no one told me that much about God. So I drew my conclusions from things that I found in. Later, I carried my questions up the steps of St. John the Divine. And noticed the shimmering lingered even after I'd walked back outside. Is it living in temples and shrines? Does it shine down from the heavens? Does it well up from the planet, reach out from inside? Where does sacred reside? could sit patiently waiting for that breeze to come finger my cheek. I could sit waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting all week. Or I could pry off the cover and search for the broken wire. Try to repair my connection to the
So after that first meeting, people got proactive. They got down in the lot and owned it. They let people know Harmony was all about peace and love.
This is Harmony. Harmony means we're supposed to get along, so let's keep that together. A lot of things have been happening bad in Harmony, which shouldn't be happening, so let's try to keep the peace together, all right? Let's try to keep it together, all right? I'm just hanging out, waiting for some friends. If you guys, try to keep the peace, then I'll try to keep the peace. That's why I'm here, you know what I mean? Because this is Harmony, you know? This ain't hurt somebody, you know? This is Harmony Lot.
We love everyone.
Peace, love, friendship.
But usually there's some pretty good-natured hippies around, but not lately.
The symbol, it could probably go on the side or, maybe right here.
So how did you know it was the 50th anniversary of the peace symbol?
Bob told me. And it's a very interesting history. It's Navy flags. The letter N and the letter D form the peace symbol, and it's nuclear disarmament. In 58, 50 years ago this year, a textile artist, he wanted to stop the stockpiling of nuclear arms. And then with Martin Luther King, one of his marchers and friends brought it here.
It's my hair.
Wow. It's made from two buses.
And this is the 12 Tribes bus?
Yes.
Does it have a name?
Peacemaker. And we built that out of two different buses. It's a 61 GM chassis with a 51 aero coach. So we put it together in 87. It's been a lot of miles.
How many miles?
Oh, I guess well over a million so far. Since 87, we've helped many, many people on Grateful Dead tours as medical help, and also the fish tour, and different events all over.
They made it. Did you hear him talking about it?
Really?
Oh. This is amazing.
I know.
We've go just as volunteers, just to be there with the people, take care of them, and whatever we can do to help. It goes along with our dancing and our music and wow. Our whole life.
This is a great truck. I'm Sam.
Wow, yeah, Sam. I'm Paul.
How you doing, Paul?
Yeah. Damn. So it'll be here for
the
weekend.
Coolest thing I've ever seen.
Well, you wonder why I'm so happy. It's because I'm anxious for nothing. And when you come into the community, you don't have a reason to be anxious for anything, because we take care of each other and we love each other.
What you find is peace for your soul.
That's right. It's a wonderful life.
Yeah, there's been some activity that we don't really like, so.
Been a lot
we've
of kind of
moved out, but we're hoping the atmosphere gets back to the
we want to have like a Harmony parking lot revolution.
Yeah.
All the bands that are playing there that night basically support us wanting Harmony to be more peaceful, though.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
We're tired of
all. We all
the
used to hang out here, but then stuff happened.
Yeah. I mean, we like Harmony because there's the great like
atmosphere.
Like there's
yeah.
the common ground, the tinderbox.
There's like the upper crust. I always get the name wrong.
We're hoping it gets back to normal soon.
Books. Everyone's books. I like that bookstore.
Yeah, we don't want people getting beat up in front of like...
A bookstore, yeah.
Yeah, a bookstore.
We like to accept everyone. Mm-hmm. It's like a big happy family. I wish when I clap my hands together, a rainbow would just happen, be like, diversity.
I've never been to this lot.
Anna?
This is my first time. Is it yours, Harriet?
We've been here before when our son has been here. Tim is our son. I live in the house where I grew up.
For how many years have you lived in that house, if you were born there?
If I were born, well, I'm 64 now, so...
No, you're older than that. Now, that's like...
I mean 84. Because we came here to see our son. And he's in the band down there.
At Molesai?
Yes.
He's playing Tim. In the band.
Tim Thrasher. He's my son. And we love him dearly. I'm Harriet Thrasher. And my husband, Alden. And we were just here to see our son in the band. That's Tim Thrasher. He's a nice boy.
And there's the famous artist, Mr. Al Thrasher.
Nice of you to connect with us here.
Yeah.
Well, and this is harmony. Harmony means we're supposed to get along. Well, this is harmony love.
Come November, the Harmony Lot Neighborhood Association had a second meeting to assess their progress.
We put together a small costume party. In Harmony parking lot.
Great time we got to speak with the young people. There was a great rapport where they were able to see what we were trying to do.
Come on down. It's Harmony Place, where everything is beautiful. Unless I touch it, I ruin your day.
Trick treat.
Cash prize for the best costumes.
Happy Halloween.
We're doing this to try to show that we can all get along in a peaceful manner without this rivalry between us.
Deaf, welcome to Deaf, the Harmony's first annual Halloween party. And I want you to come this year and every year. And if I catch up with you, well, you won't be there the next year. But happy Halloween! Deaf! Jeff! My friend here, Witch Hazel, who flew in just for the event. Sometimes he's a real bore, but boy, what a fuck.
Smile, sweetheart.
That we're all Brattleboro residents and we need to do this to keep it safe for all of us.
Thank you, remote. She's a couch potato.
Oh boy.
People in agencies and grocery stores and everybody that helped us. Okay.
Little fella.
She's our little stinker.
There's no place like Harmony, Brattleboro, Vermont.
Second place.
Harmony Park can be positive.
Yeah!
Yay! Yeah.
Just stay away from his tail, because if that thing kicks you.
You do want that? Okay, it's kind of hard to hear out here. Yeah.
Thank you.
I have met, getting this organized, I have met, I'm going to say about 10 or more young people, but now I can talk to one-on-one, that we communicate. I don't think they're scared of me because I'm old, and I'm not scared of them because they're young. So it's a start.
I don't know, Mom.
The good stuff. The good stuff.
That is the good stuff. We got the food co-op here.
Oh, I love the good stuff.
Bye, Dad.
Bye, Mom. Great.
Okay, that's what we're going to
Are you going to talk to us? Wait, man.
I won again, and we'll see you sooner or later here at the Harmony Halloween Festival!
Yes, house all summer long. I live at Brooke's house and come in through the back way and right across from sun-dried tomatoes under the stairs that go up Brooke's house building. There was zucchini flowers, and I kept watching them. I didn't touch them. And then there were like three or four zucchini about this big, very big. And so I asked the restaurant owners, are these yours? And they said no, so I picked two and gave one to my daughter, and I made our bread. Harmony parking lot maple zucchini bread. And what's even kind of ironic is I feel like I can definitely talk, whereas I felt alienated from the young people, I feel like I can now talk with them.
I mean, you saying this, it's like touching to me. And, you know, you see someone and they're scary or they look different than we do. And, you know, everybody's like, you know, people talking to people makes such a huge difference.
I am on one huge, enormous ego quest to make meaningful, beautiful ideas happen every single day.
My name is Stephen Ironside. I live here in town.
I got my start in art as entertaining myself in the 50s and 60s. I lived with people that were a generation removed from my own, and they always wanted to ditch me so they could be with the adult crowd. And in my case, they urged me to draw because they liked my work, and I found it entertaining.
You were raised by your grandmother?
My supposed auntie. She's she's very elderly now. She was born in the 20s. 1920s.
And how come you were raised by your auntie?
I think that she's responsible for that more than myself, because she believes her brother is my father. My real start in art, though, honestly, now that you reminded me, was winning a contest. The day you win a coming first in a drawing contest is your day to realize that, damn, what happened there? Blame is a fruitless sort of endeavor. To lay blame for the missing frogs, that's not me, kid, but still the frogs are missing. So Mr. Chairman, like I said in the cartoon, might be the guy we want to ask. If I can get them to pause for even a few seconds, that's a fairly likely chance of success.
I bring these along because they're Italian clay, very red.
It is a natural thing in the earth. Evaporation is a big part of drawing and painting. My auntie was the most formidable woman. She did cruel. Cruel's no joke. She could talk, drink, watch TV, and do cruel all at the same time. She put me up to as a young man. The one I remember most was Eric Fromm. She would put me up to penning in calligraphy Eric Fromm poems, and so This is the poem. So Mary Alice was telling me that the Maoists insisted upon agricultural self-sufficiency, but they've depleted the aquifers under Asia. In 10 years, they won't be able to pump water from underground there. They'll be reliant upon rain. And that's why the Three Rivers Gorge Project and the fatal attraction to the Himalayas exists, probably, because they can drink them. You tell them you heard it here. See what you got going there. Seems like water everywhere. Until there's none on my tongue. Found some pictures of some on Mars. But my cup is the Lesser Sahara. That's all the world stage needs a drink before and after.
Deanna Garcia, who'd always lived in the city and never had a garden before, wanted to make a green spot out of Harmony Lot.
Well, we're trying to get this cleaned up to, I suppose the wall and get the garden going for my mother-in-law.
We're trying to expose the wall, the natural wall there. We're bringing in some plants, some indigenous plants.
It's actually Marcy's birthday, so
oh, yeah.
this is...
Yeah. This is what you wanted to do on your birthday?
It is. I love doing work outside. We're trying to clean up this area, this little breezeway step area, so we can all have somewhere to come sit, maybe read a book, and just make it more inviting.
But you don't live in Brattleboro, do you?
I don't, but I come here so often to shop, to see my mother, to do business. The parking lot's dear to me. It's dear to all of us.
When we had the Halloween party, it was full of candy. Now it's summer and it's full of, I think it's vegetables. I don't know. Worms.
Jump basket has a hole.
The zucchini that I thought was wild was, found out it's Jim's, the maintenance man. It was his. I think I had more fun digging in the dirt and finding good stuff, bad stuff, odd stuff. What is this? Shallots. These I got out in the woods.
What a great mom you've got.
She is a good mom. She's a good friend.
You can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family.
A never boring moment.
Tell you one thing that's funny. Rudyard Kipling used to play poker up there because it took so long for the police to get up the stairs. cursed, and how come there's no water faucets? You know, how come I can't get a hose? What? Well, these buildings were built before water... before water spigots, I think. But last year, it just seemed a little... a little scarier, and all winter it was gray. Spring's been gray. I think getting all the extra policemen that they hired is a good thing. It's a real good thing.
Hello.
And if you look real hard, you can't see much dirt. Tree grows in Brooklyn, and a tomato plant grows in Harmony.
Deanna made her dream come true. Now the Stairs to Nowhere is a hidden spot where people can gather, talk, eat, study, read, exchange ideas, and just enjoy a cool breeze. It's true, Harmony Lot has changed over the years, but there are still hippies in the lot.
So what's your name?
Jordan.
Do you hang out in Harmony Lot quite a bit?
Yeah. With my brother.
How long have you been hanging out with Harmony Lot?
Probably ever since I was like 5. So, I'm 10 right now.
Well, what do you like about Harmony Lot?
Well, I just like that it's like not a bunch of war going on, like not doing anything.
It's
just like
Jordan.
Hanging out.
I brought her to the show at the Tinderbox to bring her to her first concert show.
And little boys who want to learn to skate.
Johnson City, Tennessee, and I gotta get a move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name, and I know that she's the only one. But if I die in Raleigh, at least I will die free. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, and away. Hey, mama, rock me.
And the crowd goes wild.